Se está presentando ahorita, mira.
Absolutely, Sally. Well, we're so glad that you could meet our competitors for today's challenges. And now let's review the senses that they may have to use. First, we have hearing, taste, sight, smell, and touch. Now, sea lions will use all of these senses in a variety of ways to survive in the wild. The first one is a familiar sea lion bark. And each individual sea lion has its own unique bark, like big screens. Of course, it's his nose. So we're going to see if we can get a great look at Jenny's nose up there. And I want you guys to watch what he can do with his nostrils. There's his nose. See how he can open and close those nostrils? Now there's a reason that sea lions do that. It's because they're mammals, so they breathe air like you and I. When a sea lion dives into the water, they close their nostrils to prevent the water. Did you know a sea lion can even hold its breath for up to 20 minutes?
Hey there, Carrie. We're going to turn that fun fact into our next
sea lion challenge.
We're going to see who can hold the most air in their lungs by blowing into a whistle for the longest amount of time. Let's check in with the competitors and see who is up for this challenge.
Heck yeah.
It states that before a sea lion can win by forfeit, an audience member must be given the opportunity to compete. So what do you say? Do I have a volunteer willing to come down here and do a whistle challenge with Surfer? Raise those hands up nice and high. Would you want to be my volunteer? All right, let's give a big round of applause for volunteers. Come on down here. We're going to go center stage right here and turn and face your...
Oh!
Carrie, that was pretty cool watching them find their shape.
Allows the sea lion to regulate its body temperature. This whole process is called thermoregulation. Now Jenny's learning to show the audience how he can wrap to the center of the pool. So let's see if he can head out there and show you.
No creo que le alcance. ¿Será que le alcanza? Se va a ir hasta el fondo.
Well, you did a fantastic job of that. Something else that sea lions use for touch are their whiskers, which are also called their vibrissae. Now, sea lions have a great set of whiskers, and they'll use them when they're hunting in deep, dark, and murky waters. When they can't see the fish, they'll use those whiskers to feel for the vibrations that the fish make in the water. Now, Jenny's also learning to show the audience his whiskers up there on the big screen. We're going to see if he can flare them for all of you and show you how easily sea lions can move those whiskers.
Oh.
And he's doing a great job with this new behavior that he's learning.
I'd like all of you to clap your hands just once